If you're assigned to it, there's an alignment for it. Jonah said, I ain't going to Nineveh. I'm going the other way. Come on, y'all. Will y'all just help me? I'm going the other way. Any Jonahs in the room? Oh, y'all are so. You know what? When the Lord saved y'all, you're going to get delivered. And you're going to be able to tell the truth. Any Jonahs in the room? Because there's some stuff that you've been assigned to. There's some people that you've been assigned to. And watch this. And there's some other folk that have been assigned to you. Hallelujah. What do you mean assigned to me? Some folk are like sandpaper. They're assigned to you to keep rubbing you the wrong way.
Jacob and Israel. You got to be one or the other.
finished on Wednesday. Can I just share something with y'all? I said it in, I don't know where I said it, because I've been talking. Because this thing has been in me. But we don't believe in absolutes anymore. We don't believe that you're absolutely going to heaven. Or you absolutely going to hell. So we think that we can be Jacob and Israel. That we can have the best of both worlds. But you can't. But Thomas said, when Jacob fought with the angel, he said, "What's your name?" And he whispered his name because he was embarrassed to say. So this is what God says. No more whispering. Oh, come on, that was the inspiration of the Holy Ghost. Come on, look at somebody and say, no more whispering. No more that holding your head down. My name. No. You are redeemed. No. I don't care what you were in. You are redeemed. Hold your head up. Lift your head up. Square your shoulders. And you tell them that I am the finished product of what Jesus did at Calvary. They'll say, yeah, but I know when. And say, that was when. But this is now. Now am I sanctified. Watch this. Say with me, messy circumstances are unaligned prophecies. One more time. Messy circumstances are unaligned prophecies. What are you talking about, Pastor? I'm saying that if your life is a mess right now, it's just an unaligned prophecy. It can be a mess. Stuff can be jacked up. But guess what? God's prophecy is still intact. You're saying there's a prophecy over my life that I'm going to own my own business, that the Lord is going to send me to the nations, that this is going to happen, but I don't have any money. That's just a messy circumstance because it's an unaligned prophecy. So you got to tell your circumstances to line up with your prophecy. You got to tell your circumstances to line up with your, come on, prophecy. That he said, I'm the head and not the tail. So I'm tired of tail living. Ain't nobody talking to me. Van said, listen, I'm sick of working this job. And there's a prophecy over my life. I've got a covenant with God. So now I want my circumstances to line up with my prophecy. When people look at you and say, your life is messy. Your circumstances are jacked up. You need to look back at them and say, I know, they're just all over the place. But God is going to take this piece and that piece and this mess and that mess and this brokenness and that heartache, and he's going to put them together. And when you see me again, can I get some real people? Only real people can do this. Church people can't. Real people can do this. Watch this. Real people touch another person and say, I'm a little messy now.
Divine alignment.